in 2016, more than 40,000 individuals lost their lives to this crisis. And that's a significant human impact. We feel strongly to have the opportunity to leverage our technology to contribute in some way to positively affect that situation. If we can help get faster and more accurate data in the hands of practitioners, policymakers, industry leaders to make increasingly more effective decisions, that's truly a win for us and drives us to continually refine our systems, be better, be more aggressive, and move forward diligently. Mission Lisa is our overarching project focused on the opioid crisis, and actually emerged out of a discussion that we were having somewhat unrelated with a large healthcare provider, hospital systems across the country, and their interest in seeing if we could help identify diversion and other issues within their supply chain, particularly in the pharmaceutical area and the drug area. And what emerged out of that discussion was a focus on the opioid epidemic and its systemic impacts on their care networks and their patients that were in their communities, the impact on the practitioners that were serving those communities, and whether or not our data systems ingesting this massive inflow of open source information off of the internet and then structuring that and identifying relationships, if we could somehow figure out a way to tailor that and focus it on reducing the cycle times and improving the data surrounding this crisis. Our approach to the crisis is to develop data systems that are focused on breaking it down into three parts, and that's prevention, treatment, and interdiction. And so our immediate priority is focused on prevention. It's how do we build out systems to where we better understand who's being affected. More than 70% of overdoses occur outside of a medical or a healthcare provider environment. And so looking at that, there's a gap in the data and the cycle times that practitioners have to be able to gain accurate information about where the crisis is, where you start to see inflection points across the population, and then how do you allocate resources, how do you push people into treatment programs and start to address this at the base level. And so our prime focus right now in the next year is building out systems that help empower practitioners with near real-time information about where heavily impacted populations are located across the country and what the trend is in terms of the shifts in addiction across those communities. And on the prevention side, looking at what are the immediate first and second order impacts and what policy can be made to help drive people and market to people to get them into programs, to help them connect with specific treatment regimens, whether that's medically assisted treatment or others, and looking at the reasons why there's that recidivism among those populations and seeing if we can't help with that. Our primary use of technology is a combination of largely unsupervised machine learning technology that is specialized in ingesting massive amounts of information, structured, unstructured information and data off of the indexed web and the non-indexed web. And the benefit of that is, one, you get everything that's going on in social media, but then in addition to that, you bring in everything else. And that's one piece of it, is being able to collect that information, but then making sense of it is a significant challenge. And making sense of it at scale and in reducing the cycle times where you can do so increasingly quickly. And our technology is various different types of artificial intelligence that allow us to pull out the names of entities, identify relationships, and then identify those relationships and the sentiments surrounding that and the various topic lines within that content and tie that back to people and then tie that back to different topics. And so in this case, it's heavily focused on trying to better understand patterns within addicted populations and understand that nexus to individuals who have passed away from an overdose and those individuals who are not yet affected, who then may be at a greater systematic risk of being affected due to whether that's various types of social network affiliation or general geographic location, a number of different attributes, but pulling all that together in a way where there's a high fidelity data stream for a policymaker to make decisions based on it. The two biggest barriers are are the fairly long cycle times between an event happening and collecting the data and then having that data in a refined form for a practitioner to use, but then also the lack of standardization across different data sources to be able to start to pull all of that together into a much broader data set. The future of the opioid crisis in the United States is one where we tackle it. There's a great number of efforts moving forward today where you start to see a critical mass of organizations, people, resources moving in the same direction on this. And I think what we'll see is, even though we're still seeing increases in addicted populations and in overdoses, I think the trend is starting to flatten out. And you'll start to see, as we tailor these approaches, I think we'll start to see the reverse and be able to really get this under control. I think you're seeing a broader variety in how individuals are treated in terms of, there's a number of programs that are focused on prescription monitoring to quickly identify potential abuse of a prescription. There's also more increasingly creative ways about how to handle pain management and those different programs. Collectively, you have a number of different disciplines that are coming together and understanding the interdisciplinary nature of and the complex nature of the crisis. And as we move through that, I think we'll see the reversal of this. I think we'll have a long-run situation where we have this under control.